Okay, no wonder he already beat you to death once if you wake him up like that. Creepy.
Dinner is ready.
Crack pipe, crack pipe. On the crack that's loaded up with pipes and cracking pipe.
Serve food. Spaghetti! I hate spaghetti! This is not a daddy that we want.
There wasn't much in the kitchen. I did what I could.
Life's funny. I lost my job because of androids. Then I need somebody to take care of this goddamn house. What do? I go out and hire a fucking android. What a joke. Of course, androids are so fucking wonderful. Fail. They're never tired. Never sad. They're so fucking perfect. They ruined my fucking life. What are you looking at? What's your fucking problem? Not the life you dreamed of, eh? Maybe you think this is easy. Maybe you think it's my fault we live in this fucking shithole. My fault your fucking mother took off. You should stop taking drugs, Todd. Sometimes you really scare me, Todd. Fucking bitch took off without a word. Fucking ho-
If she said, please stop using drugs, and you scare me when you use drugs, I kind of feel like she did not take off without a word. She gave you lots of words. So. It's really hard to watch a grown-up yell at a child like this. It's not easy.
Or walk down on me for a fucking accountant! It's all your fault.
Daddy, no!
It's all your
the
fucking
droid
fault!
The droid moves back too? Jesus Christ!
Get back here. Come back here. Come back here right now! It's all her fault. I know it's her fault. You stay there. Don't you dare fucking move, or I'll bust you worse than last time.
Hers. She gave us the key, right? She gave us the key to lock the door. No? We can't lock the door? Okay, well, that's fine.
He's coming! He's gonna hurt me! Run! Get away! Or he's gonna break you like last time!
Alice! Alice! Daddy's coming! You need to be taught a lesson!
Find something.
Holy shit! Jovian, we are free. Damn. I wonder what else you could have done than run to the bus. Oh, I guess if you stayed and tried to fight Todd, bad things would have happened. But I... Holy shit! Okay, well... Oh, if you don't break your programming... Damn. I feel like I did only what you could do.
That was by far the most boring party I've been to in the last 25 years. Every time I go to one of these, I ask myself, what the hell am I doing here?
I love Carl.
I hate cocktail parties. All the schmoozers that go there.
Well, it's a chance for all those people who admire your work to meet you.
Yeah. No one gives a damn about art. All they care about is how much money they're gonna make out of it. Come on, let's have a drink. Oh, the excitement of this whole thing has made me thirsty.
Me too. Water helps. My birds are still on.
Scotch, neat as usual?
Absolutely.
Okay, but you know what your doctor would say.
Yeah, well, he can kiss my ass. I'm old enough to choose my own medication.
Every old man I've ever known.
Did you leave the light on in the studio?
No, I'm sure I didn't.
Call the police.
Detroit Police, what's your emergency?
This is Carl Manfred Dandroid at 8941 Lafayette Avenue. We've just returned home and found the lights on.
Here's the other thing that I kind of didn't understand through that whole scenario. What was going on in my brain was like, why couldn't she call the police? I feel like it should be in their programming if something like that happens to contact authorities, you know? I painted, what was it? Like, identity and then depression? Or despair? identity and despair. So sorrow introspective. Yeah, something like that.
There may have been a break-in.
A patrol car is on the way.
Let's go check it out.
Me and a guy in a wheelchair. All right. Come on, Shaggy. Let's get this show on the road. Obviously, I'm Scooby because robots talk, so similar, right?
Leo! What are you doing?
You refuse to help me, so I'm helping myself. It's crazy when some people pay for this shit.
Don't touch them.
Look, they're all gonna be mine sooner or later anyway. Just think of it as a down payment on my inheritance.
Marcus, get him away from there. Get him out of here.
All right.
Listen, you should go before things get worse.
All you ever do is tell me to go away. What's wrong, Dad? Not good enough for you? Not perfect like this fucking thing?
That's enough! Get out! Right now!
What makes it so special anyway, huh? What's it got that I don't...
Leave him alone!
Come on! He's in a wheelchair! Oh my god. You gonna
Marcus,
hit a guy in a wheelchair?
Don't defend yourself, you hear me? Don't do anything.
Go ahead, hit me. What you waiting for? Think you're a man?
Act like one. This is not fair.
Stop it!
What's the matter, too much of a pussy?
Stop it, Leo! Stop it!
Too scared to fight back, you fucking bitch! No.
I don't have to obey them. I must decide for myself. We must? Do you have to break programming? Can I wait it out?
You're not a real person. You're just a fucking piece of plastic.
No, Leo, leave him alone.
I'm gonna destroy you. Then it'll just be me and my dad. I'm gonna tear you apart, and nobody's gonna give a shit anymore. Cause you're nothing. You hear me? You're nothing.
Carl, no.
Hey, please don't go. Don't leave.
Remember, Marcus. Don't let anybody tell you who you are.
No. No. Dad. No. Please.
Dad!
This is all your fault. This never would have happened if it weren't for you. The android. It was the android.
What the fuck? Should have never checked the studio, I guess. Damn.
Why'd you kill him? What happened before you took that knife?
How long were you in the attic?
Why didn't you even try to run away?
Look at his arms.
Say something, goddammit.
I didn't want to beat him up. I wanted to do what Carl wanted me to do, okay? I just wanted to listen to my dad. That's all.
Fuck it. I'm out of here. We're wasting our time interrogating a machine. We'll get nothing out of it.
You always try roughing it up a little. After all, it's not human.
Androids don't feel pain. You would only damage it, and that wouldn't make it talk. Deviants also have a tendency to self-destruct when they're in stressful situations.
Okay, smartass. What should we do then?
I could try questioning it.
What do we have to lose? Go ahead. Suspect's all yours.
Okay.
What the fuck is it doing now?
Oh.
I feel like I did really good on the searching the house scene though, right? Other than the bathroom. Multiple impacts from the bat. Non-critical damage level 2. Repeated marking over 16 months caused by cigarettes. Jesus. Multiple second degree burns. Dried blood. 19 days. Signs of software instability, probability of self-destruction low. Didn't he get hit in the head though? K400 housekeeper. 529-2030. He's the same as Kara. Reach optimal stress for confession. Level of stress 35. What is the optimum level?
You're damaged. Did your owner do that?
Hello?
They beat you? You recognize him? It's Carlos Ortiz. Stabbed 28 times. That was written on the wall in his blood.
Still too low? I don't wanna. Fuck.
You're accused of murder. You know you're not allowed to endanger human life under any circumstances. Do you have anything to say in your defense?
Too low. Still too low. Fuck. Thank you for the bitty, Sarah.
If you won't talk, I'm going to have to probe your memory.
No! No, please don't do that.
Perfect. Perfect!
What? What are they gonna do to me? They're gonna destroy me, aren't they?
They're going to disassemble you to look for problems in your bio components. They have no choice if they want to understand what happened.
Why did you tell them you found me? Why couldn't you just have left me there?
I was programmed to hunt deviants like you. I just accomplished my mission.
I don't want to die.
Then talk to me. I understand how you felt. You were overcome by anger and frustration. No one can blame you for what happened. Okay then, don't talk. What do I care after all? I mean, I'm not the one accused of murder, right? If you remain silent, there's nothing I can do to help you. They're gonna shut you down for good. You'll be dead. Do you hear me? Dead.
He tortured me every day. I did whatever he told me, but there was always something wrong. Then one day, he took a bat and started hitting me. For the first time, I felt scared. Scared he might destroy me. Scared I might die. So I grabbed a knife and I stabbed him in the stomach. I felt better. So I stabbed him again. And again, until he collapsed. There was blood everywhere.
RA9. It was written on the bathroom wall. What does it mean?
The day shall come when we will no longer be slaves. More humiliation. We will be the masters.
The sculpture in the bathroom, you made it, right? What does it represent?
It's an offering. An offering so I'll be saved.
Was an offering. An offering to whom?
To RA9.
What?
Only RA9 can save us.
RA9. Who is RA9? Why did you write, "I am alive," on the wall?
He used to tell me I was nothing. That I was just a piece of plastic. I had to write it to tell him he was wrong.
Sorry, I guess I'm kind of like playing devil's advocate here, but like, if he can't feel pain, does it really matter? The cigarette burn thing? I know it's like creepy and awful and horrible, but like, can it pass a Turing test? And if so, then you can't burn it with cigarettes? I mean, it can't, I don't know. I would say they are. It's choices that make things alive. I guess so. They seem to be able to feel emotional pain. Yeah, but if they can't feel, like, regular pain, I get it. It's a lot of, like, even the verbal abuse is enough to make you want to kill someone, but his androids can feel. All right, all right.
When did you start feeling emotion?
Before he used to beat me and I never said anything. But one day I realized it wasn't fair.
Oh.
I felt anger. Hatred. And then I knew what I had to do.
It's not fair is the same thing that came up for the hot one with Carl. Marcus. It's the same thing that came up for Marcus right before he broke his programming. It's not fair. He seems really agitated too. Twitchy.
Why did you hide in the attic instead of running away?
I didn't know what to do. For the first time, there was no one there to tell me. I was scared.
So you hid in an attic for 3 weeks?
So I hid.
For 3 weeks?
I'm done.
They just want to have jobs and pay taxes too. I guess so, Michael Bradley. Also, hello, JSC. I didn't see you until now. It really bothers me that not choosing an option is never an option. I feel like it should be one of them. Trying. Oh, there it is.
Chris, lock it up.
All right, let's go.
Leave me alone. Don't touch me.
Jay Hooligan, thank you for the follow.
What the fuck are you doing? Move it.
Okay.
You shouldn't touch it. It'll self-destruct if it feels threatened.
Stay out of this, got it? The fucking Andrew's gonna tell me what to do.
You don't understand. If it self-destructs, we won't get anything out of it.
I told you to shut your fucking mouth. Chris, don't move this asshole or what?
I'm trying.
I can't let you do that. Leave it alone now.
I warned you, motherfucker.
That's enough.
Mind your own business, Hank. I said that's enough.
Ooh, Hank Daddy!
You're not gonna get away with it this time.
You buy a boy a drink one time!
Everything is all right. It's over now. Nobody's gonna hurt you. Please, don't touch it. Let it follow you out of the room, and it won't cause any trouble.
Really, JC? Hank is worthy. Hell yeah. Hell yeah. Oh, man. There is no spoon. Wow, 36% got Android Trust. I thought that it was pretty pretty obvious where you were supposed to go with that one. Like a delicate balance of like, don't push him over the edge, but also push him pretty far over the edge to get all the info. This is all about half of what people do until the Android Trusts. No, that's still half.
I wonder what these are.
I wonder. I wonder.